In this video, let's learn how accessing blockchain state is different on Ethereum and Algorand. Blockchain is a ledger that contains various types of records that may be relevant to the application that you're building. For example, if you want to display how much of token A an account holds in the front end of your application, you will need to query the blockchain ledger and get that information. So in general, smart contracts need to access blockchain records to do certain things. On Ethereum, if a smart contract needs to access certain data from the blockchain ledger, the query accesses the entire ledger and finds the data from it. Now, it's great that you have access to the entire ledger all the time, but it's also slow and expensive to complete that search as you're trying to find certain data from the entire ledger. So in short, Ethereum prioritizes open data availability over scalability. Algorand, on the other hand, is designed to prioritize high TPS and low latency. So to prevent blockchain state query, which can be slow and expensive, from slowing down the network, the AVM restricts the amount of resources smart contracts can query per transaction. So for example, if your Algorand smart contract needs to access an account balance or a smart contract state, the smart contract call transaction must include the references to these resources in the reference array. Now, this allows nodes to prefetch the reference resources for the smart contract to use during execution. Now, this restriction may seem like a strong limitation, but most smart contracts know in advance what resources they need to access to be functional. So by explicitly specifying the resources the transaction can access, smart contract calls can be properly executed in a fast manner. Also, with a recent update to the Simulate endpoint, which is an endpoint that devs can use to simulate transactions without actually sending the transaction to the Algorand network, Algorand smart contracts can now automatically detect what resources they need and include all the resources they will access in the reference array for you. So as a developer, you no longer need to manually define the reference array. So in terms of developer experience, there really is no difference between how you would send a smart contract call on Ethereum compared to how you would do it on Algorand.